And welcome along to my first of many, many Serum 2 tutorials on this channel. I am loving it sick at the moment. And for today's sound, I'm going to be diving into this Noisia style bass like this. Well done, X Records. Well done, Steve. Bang on, plug it. First of all, we're going to be using all three oscillators, noise oscillator, and a brand new filter that comes with Serum 2. First oscillator is actually going to be from the OG Serum wavetables. We want Monster 7. OSB is also going to be spectral, going to be squelchy number 3. Lastly, OSC is going to be default shapes and just classic sine wave. Two octaves down for the first one, up 1 and plus 7 semitones for the second. Lovely sound. Crank the wavetable position for the first one. Randomization off for first, off for second, off for third. What a beautiful sound. Filter one is going to be diffuser. You can find that in S2 filters. So sick. This is going to be taking signal from OS A and noise as well. We should probably do noise. Let's do that now. It's going to be color white. Bit of a filter around 70%. And we'll switch this off for the time being because we're going to LFO map that. Diffuser up around 2K. Yeah, that'll do. Resonance, 22. Drive, 23. Stages, 34. Lovely sound. We need some FM, we need some LFO action and all that good shit. Before we get into the FM, we're going to draw our LFO shape first. And this is going to be set to triplets and 8. 8th T, which is 8th triplets. And whatever kind of shape we really want this to be, I'm going to have like a weird kind of pluck sound. I'm going to leave quite a broad section right towards the end because I want to LFO this in a way that just opens this up, so extends the sound a little bit longer. This is going to be grounded to a few things. First of all, it's going to be the level of OS B. So it's going to be up around here. Also level of OS A. We can turn that off. A little bit more of a hint of what the sound's going to be. Of course, we're going to load up FM from B and FM from C. Lots of FM on this one. Going to be up around 23%. Yeah, boy. A little bit of LFO on that action. Not that much. FM from C, we're going to automate this with another LFO, but check it up around 19%. And since it's taking frequency modulation from C, I'm going to spice up C a little bit as well, alternate warp, pulse width modulation. Kind of getting the bare bones of the sound. We just need a lot of distortion, need a lot of movement to everything, and then it should be ace. And since these oscillators are doing a bit, we want the noise to do a bit as well, so LFO 2. And this is where you can kind of get a bit creative. Depends when you want like a little pluck of the sound coming through. I'm gonna have like a delayed. I'm not gonna start the pluck up here. I'm gonna have a little bit of a delayed one. So I'm just gonna map this to the level of noise. Also, it'd help if it was eighths and triplets. There we go. So it depends where you want to set this kind of noise to kick in. I like a little bit of a delay since this kind of LFO shape is delayed as well. But we do not need that much noise. It'll get accentuated once we chuck on distortion and multiband OTT onto it, so yeah. LFO 3 is going to be set to 2 bars. This is going to be our modulation over time, so a little bit slower to kick in and just ramp up towards the end, like so. Where's the curve? There it is. So first thing we can set this to is, go to the matrix, LFO 3, global tune, so we can either have it pitch up or pitch down. So a little bit more movement, but maybe not that much. Nice. Also going to set this to the diffuser on some elements as well. So chuck this on the attack. No, not the attack, cutoff. Around 10% and release. Also kind of 6-ish. And another LFO for movement, LFO 4, massive ramp up over 2 bars. And this would be subtly on FM from C on OS B, around 10%. Now let's get into more of some creative stuff, mapping LFOs to different parts of LFOs. Here's where it gets a little bit complicated, but I will walk you through it. So we want this to move in time with our third LFO. So as it ramps up towards the end, it opens up the sound just a little bit more. So that's what we're going for. So we'll start with it down here. Right click on the curve, modulation curves, LFO bus one, LFOs, and then LFO three? Yeah, it was three. So we want to just bump this up more, even more. So that's kind of what we're going for. Maybe a little bit less. Head into the matrix to help sort it even more. Alpha 3 to alpha bus 1, which is, yep, which is what we want. Start at a higher point. No, a little bit too high. I'm really happy with the tail end. And we also want to map LFO 1 and 2 since it controls the volume of all of our oscillators and noise pretty much. So I'm going to have a separate one over two bars again. This is like a two bar pattern. Just drop these. And then here's where it gets interesting. Kind of want a pattern like this. So da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. That is the intention. Nice and easy to do. So LFO 1, right click on the rate, mod source, LFOs, LFO. Five? Yeah, it was five, cool. Hint to the matrix, because that's kind of the opposite effect. I want to slow down whenever it hits these long bits. So we just swing this to the other side. You can hear the noise in the background is doing its own thing because it hasn't been switched over to this LFO mapping. So we'll go ahead and do the same thing. Right click, mod source, LFO, LFO five. And we can pretty much copy what this is doing. So this is negative 32%. So negative 32%. Let's just hear this noise is coming through. That is the body of the sound. It is sounding a bit weak at the moment. So effects, let's go. First up is obviously compressor, blah, blah, multiband. Crank up that bass, we're killing it too much. Punchy, we can come back to that. Anyway, second FX is going to be distortion. Going to use two distortion. I'm so glad they chucked in with Serum 2. The ability to use the same effect multiple times. Oh, it's so good. So we're going to utilize this with a hard clip, 86% drive. As being squeezed by the balls. Anyway, another distortion. This is going to be diode one. Okay, that's too much. A little bit of drive. And the mix can come down a lot. Oh, that sound is beautiful. And the last effect, we don't need to complicate things. Phaser, I'm gonna be dropping this around here and here. Frequency. Whatever kind of suits. Mix does not need to be that high. Phase depends if we like it wide or we like it mono. Maybe a little bit of width. But yeah, that makes sense. It does not need to be that high. We need to hear that in context with the track. A singular F note will do because it's been just played the entire time since we added a lot of movement over those two bars. And here we go. We'll make the noise wide, so a little bit more of a width element to the sound rather than just the phaser carrying the team with that. And that is that, my friends. Banging Serum 2 Noisia styled bass. The funny thing is, I was actually working towards a Serum 2 bass preset pack. And it's weird, because I kind of just reached the point, I was like, screw it, I'm just gonna show everybody how to make my favorite patch that I've made so far from this pack. So yeah, there you go, my secrets are out. Anyways, that is that. Hopefully you did enjoy Serum 2 preset pack coming eventually this year. But in the meantime, I do have a lot of banging Serum 1 presets pack. Link will be in the description if you wanna check those out. Have a great day, and see you guys next time. Peace.